So Shelby was born April 12th, 1990. Shortly after her birth, I guess in the first 6 months, Shelby wasn't meeting her milestones. And so we noticed there was something a little different and took her and to the doctor and realized that she was having seizure activity. Yeah, your brain was sending off lightning strikes, right?
Yeah.
And so it was quite shocking and quite difficult to realize that this was a birth defect.
When I want to say it was about 11 years old, Shelby had her first year at camp, and that's something that really impacted my life through high school and into adulthood. It really helped me grow as a person to see all these other people, because I lived with Shelby and I knew what to expect there, but then you see every other range of, you know, capability and disability, and it really changes the way you look at life. I can't even describe what it did to me. It made me really look at the world in a different way and you know, have more empathy and really understand that, you know, these people, they matter too. You know, as an 11-year-old kid, I learned that. These people matter.
Sending her to the ARC has been the best thing we ever did for her. Taking her out of high school, even though she could have stayed for another year or two, was probably the best thing we ever did, because she learned so much more at the ARC and being with her peers and still continued in the classroom setting. We were so concerned about the transition because she didn't do well with change, but it was like the easiest thing she's ever done, and she absolutely loves it. That is her social life. Once a month, they have a function, and what is that you like to do?
Dancing.
You love to dance.
Oh, yeah.
With the boys.
With the boys.
Good job.
Just, I think we're all really grateful that she's got a cool place like that to go. You know, just, she always got a big, huge smile on her face when she's there.
Tony and I invest a lot of time, money, support to the ARC, because without it, she would have nowhere to go. And if we didn't have the ARC, she would just be stuck at home doing nothing. And that's not her.
We do, you know, appreciate the fact that the ARC has been there for Shelby since she got out of high school. And if there's not people around to say, okay, I'm gonna donate what I donate to the ARC, then it may not have been there for Shelby in the first place, and it definitely wouldn't be there in the future for other people that need it.
As far as Shelby's future is concerned, we've been on a waiting list for 13 years. I'm 63 years old, so not getting any younger, and Shelby's 28. I think she would do well in a group home environment and gain some independence. But we're waiting on funding from the state.